after academia, where did you go next?
Oof, that's after academia. Actually, I started my company. I was in Spain, and I remember receiving a call from Pablo de León. He's a very good, renowned space suit designer, originally from Argentina. He's faculty at the University of North Dakota. And he called me, had done a space show, and they were interviewing me about radiation. And he called me to say, hey, Irene, would you like to come write a proposal together with us to we're submitting a proposal for a grant from NASA to fund a full-scale lunar simulation? And I said, of course, sure enough. He said, we need radiation. We like what you are saying and come on board. So yeah, sure enough, we wrote it, we won it. And so that's one of the things I'm doing right now. And so basically I started the path of independent consultant, and then a year later I thought, wait a minute, I really like this. I like the thinking challenges of coming up with the strategies. Why don't I just do it as a company? And I enlisted the friends and, you know, colleagues, you know, and they're like, sure, that's so cool. So we just did it. And here we are, and we're getting great responses, and you know, we're very excited about the whole new movement of commercial space. I mean, I think it's an amazing moment in history.
The professor at North Dakota, his name?
Pablo de León.
Pablo de León. He heard of you first on
the space show. How?
That's Dr. Space.
That's the Dr. Space. I've been many times on his space show, and he heard me. He didn't hear me first. He heard me. We actually had met when the Mars Society invited me to participate. That was years ago. To participate as a researcher and do a radiation simulation, you know, sort of exercise, thought, Gedanken thought, you know, Gedanken experiment. To go to their Mars, the desert research station. And I was part of Crew 69, I was their radiation person. And so Pablo de León asked the team, hey, would you mind if I come test my spacesuits out in the desert? Because, you know, the desert of Utah, it's so Martian-like, the way it looks, the way it feels, you know. And so we said, absolutely, this is fabulous. I mean, a person, you know, researcher that is funded from NASA, actually doing real spacesuits. So he came and stayed there, and we had the most fun. At dinner time, this was hilarious, and we were making jokes, and, you know, and we're waking up at 4 a.m. to go out there in the 5 a.m. before the sun went up, because the spacesuits, the person inside was so hot. And when the sun came up in the desert, this was such a impossible, he was sweating, you know, it was snow. So we had to go like at 4 a.m. out there. And I can tell you, one of the most beautiful sceneries and moments that I've lived in my life is being in the middle of nowhere with a crew of fantastic people, you know, running experiments, feeling the beauty of the desert, which is there's nothing, it's complete desolation, and there's a beauty to it. And so we bonded. His wife was there, you know, and so he said, oh, okay. And then years later, he heard me in the space and said, okay, come on board. Let's do this.